Today we'll discuss what is market-based pricing. There are different types which is considered to determine the market-based pricing. First one is the market condition approach. It is an approach or a term used as a common sense or a price followership. By adopting this approach, a hotel considers that what they compare the other hotels or their geographical area charging for similar room rates or products. They compare themselves with the hotels which are available in their areas, so that they can determine before considering the or before deciding upon the rate. The philosophy behind this approach is that a hotel can only charge prices which the market will accept. Therefore, prices are detected by the competition. So they, according to this market-based pricing, they cannot charge any rate as per they cannot charge any rates. That has to be compared or that has to be detected through the competition, that they need to know that what is how much the rates are being charged in the by the other hotel. So whatever comes in your mind, you cannot charge that particular rate. So you have to make sure you have done a research on it and approach a local market and determine and check what are the other hotels are charging. Second point here is the top-down pricing. This approach is often used by the companies entering a new market or trying to identify gap which is unfilled. This method of pricing will still require an element of cost-based pricing in order to ensure that the prices being charged are realistic and will result in an overall return on investment. That means your hotel is entering a new market. So you need to identify the gap, that what are the rates, what rates you are going to charge is it applicable, will you be able to charge that rate. That is the consideration you have to make. Then we have rate cutting. This approach assumes that demand will increase if prices are lowered, but we do not know. However, the rate cutting can be risky and may also lead competitors to cut their rates. So rate cutting is something, whenever you are deciding upon rate cutting, you need to make sure that you should not go down very low, so that tomorrow you will face a problem. So whenever a hotel decides upon a rate cutting, they need to take into account the certain points or need to consider the surrounding hotels. So if you are cutting down your rates today, the possibility that tomorrow the other hotel might also cut down their rate. So you have to be very careful whenever you are cutting down the rate. Then we have prestige product pricing. This approach takes that the view that raising the price of a room will make a hotel more exclusive and thus change the nature of the overall product. This method seems to defy the law of economics and will work only if the market is not price conscious. Prestige product pricing is more or less a psychological activity. So this approach is something like raising the price of a room will make your hotel an exclusive one, the change of nature of overall your product. But this method might defy the law of economics also, and you need to be very conscious while you are pricing when you are pricing your product. Then we have cost-based pricing. Cost-based pricing, there are certain points that rule of thumb approach. Rule of thumb approach is something, this approach sets the room rate of a room at each level, like the say 1,000 of construction and furnishing cost per room, assuming the 70% occupancy. As an example, let us assume a 200 bedroom cost us 5 lakhs to construct a furnished. Each room therefore cost us rupees 25 lakhs, and using this approach, the average room rate will be 25 per room. As Abbott and Levy point out, this rule was devised quite some time ago when rates of interest, tax level, and expectation about appropriate rates of return were different. However, the main difficulty in adopting this approach is that it does not reflect the fundamental importance of fixed and variable cost in determining a hotel's profitability. So this is something you have to, there is a certain rule of thumb. This approach was intended for newly constructed hotels to determine a starting average price. However, it can be used for any hotel provided that the hotel operator revalues the property and calculates the rates accordingly. A hotel that was constructed in the 70s at a certain cost will have almost certainly appreciated in value. So rule of thumb is something you fix up your rates and you decide upon your, it's a re-evaluation or revaluation of your property. So you need to maintain, or you need to take out your costing price, that what will be the, what is the value of your property. That will depend on the rule of thumb. Bottom-up approach. This approach is formally known as the Herbert formula and was introduced in the United States in 1950. It is known as the bottom-up approach because, contrary what we do in normal accounting practice, we first decide how much profits is required, return on investment, and then determine the expenses for the following period, usually 1 year. So this is Herbert formula is something we decide upon the investment part, and we like what is our investment and what is the return we are getting it from them, from our investment. So this is basically taken for a year, and we then decide upon this, that this is this particular investment, how much return, whether we are in profit or we are in loss. So this comes under the bottom up approach, which is used by through Herbert formula. So that's all for today. Hope it is clear to you all.